positive thinking doesn't mean going through life with a myopic, rosy smile plastered across your face. It's much more powerful than that. It's much more muscular than that. It's not about cultivating some false sense of optimism, or not expressing the full range of emotions that you feel, or not being engaged in and aware of the events of the world or the challenges facing you or other people. No. It's about understanding that what you dwell upon in your conscious mind, whether productive or passive, whether action-oriented or negative and hopeless, whether idealistic or cynical, that is going to outpicture in your world and in your experience, because those messages accumulated are going to get delivered to and will be acted upon by your subconscious mind. So it is profoundly important that you cultivate a sense of possibility of what you really want to see in the world. Murphy also taught, and this is very important, that desires themselves are sacred. Desires themselves are almost a prophetic voice within you, cultivating and asking for production, asking for the actualization of something that you find needful in the world. That doesn't mean taking a hedonistic or go-it-alone approach to life, not at all. Because Murphy also talked about this presence of what I call cosmic reciprocity in life, that we are all part of a circuit board of connection, and that whatever you do in life, in order to be really beneficent, in order to really bestow happiness and good tidings on you, has to enter the circuit in a productive way, has to be of benefit to other people. So it's not just a question of taking this go-it-alone, value-free approach to life. No. It's a question of ever producing more fertile, productive, and generative circumstances for yourself and other people. There has to be a circuitry of benefit in what you're doing in order for it to reach you in a way that will produce more such things. If there's not a circuitry of benefit, you descend into depression, into ennui, into conflict, into unhappiness. Creation must perpetuate itself. Creation strives to perpetuate itself. So your desires have to aid and abet that process.